So you are finally here, in this place between death and rebirth, where life knows no dawn. Come then. Follow me down to the darkest depths of despair. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful blue star that fell to pestilence and rotted inside and out. The more its people clung to life, the more they suffered. Until they curse not the illness, but their fellow corrupted. Those who lived festered. Those who died. And the very last of them wished they had never been born at all. In a faraway place, a brilliant star eradicated disease. Before destroying the self-same lives it had saved. Its people sought ever greater freedoms no matter the cost. They tried to buy peace with fire and steel. And when one asked, "What is the point?" there were none left to answer. rather still existed a star without strife. Where none remembered life's trials or its joys. What its people had gained from ease, they lost to apathy. So they created the kindest, most gentle of beasts.
I have you!
There!
Were light, and its gift was as painless as it was beautiful. Bathed in its golden glow, they all slept happily ever after.
Let's give them a show! Let's give them a show!
You still stand. Your determination defies all reason. The souls within me writhe and recoil in your presence. What must I do? What pain must I visit upon you to make you surrender to despair?
No one is unbreakable. What pains one may weather may bring another to tears. But therein lies our strength. For when we fall, our brothers and sisters are there to raise us up, again and again, without end.
I see. But no matter how much hope exists, some will ever be more despair. Ever will the living curse the present and the living the future. So shall sing until life ceases to be.
No.
We cannot comprehend. We cannot know. We cannot know. Don't, please. Don't do this to them. To yourself.
Just one good strike.
We will not suffer alone. All will know our pain.
No, you don't.
In ice, a frozen waste, forever silent. Gifted them escape. and rendered yourself powerless. Bereft of the synergy you claim is your strength. Unless you need to call upon the dead once more. Defiant to the last. But you will be one with us ere long. You will be battered and torn and made to crawl. You will weep and wail and curse your impotence. Curse your life as it fades. As we did. As we died. Such pain and sorrow we felt. Such anguish and rage. We tried. But it was no use. Only when we surrendered did we find release. Only when we embraced death. So join us in despair and embrace yours. My ultimatum. What is happening?
At the end of everything, I find you, my friend. I sought something in you once, as you did in me. When at last I understood what it was, I journeyed to Shalion to seek you out. Struck a bargain with the woman who shares your gift. In exchange for lending the Scions my aid, I was given the means to come hither. Gorging upon what remained of the Mana Crystal, I reclaimed the form of the dragon. And, hungry still for our reunion, I rode the light of the stars to you. I take it this is your prey. But why does it still live? Surely it is no match for you. I assumed you would be above something so banal as despair. Am I mistaken? And I'd rather not give it. Nay, I would have preferred that we enjoy a private reunion. So come! Let us dispense with this distraction, you and I!
Struggle in vain. You will not silence our song of oblivion.
never reach it. We'll never reach the deliverance you seek. Same end, again and again. there is no happiness in life. There is only one place it may be found. No matter. You only delay the inevitable. This is fate. Your time has come. It always does.
We will stand against fate!
No matter the cost!
We've been here before. Many a time.
Thus do we know.
To never give up.
Hope will shine again!
What we saw... What I saw... This can only end in misery and desolation. No life, no star, nor the universe itself. None should hope for better.
No matter where we flew, there was only darkness, and loneliness, and pain. We couldn't find the answers Hermes yearned for. The answers he deserved. Greetings, you who are my final encounter. I wish to hear your words, share your feelings, know your thoughts. May we please be friends? Memories of a long, long journey. So many people. The thoughts of them overflowing in your heart. What they live for. What gives their lives meaning. There was never a single answer. You gather pieces of happiness, precious and fragile, only to lose them, then start again. On and on it goes, until death takes you into its gentle embrace. That which Hermes sent us to find, was there all this time? On Aetheris. Like a field of flowers, perhaps. At first a single blossom. It spreads and takes on more colours. Thank you for guiding me here. To find these words at journey's end fills me with joy. And so, before I fall forever silent, there is one thing I must do. No expression of regret will undo what my sisters and I have done, or restore what we have stolen. But if you would allow it, I would sing one last song. A song of the newfound joy that swells in my heart. Of the beauty of light when it shines across a dark and starless sea. Of a dream that from the soil of worlds now lost to sorrow, life will spring forth once more. Nourished by gentle rains and caressed by uplifting winds, a song of hope. One day, life will fill the universe again, and Hermes will see this and smile. How, I do not know. But I do know that where there is a will, there is a way. After all, miracles happen every day, do they not? Create a path back to your ship, where your dear friends await. Hold in your heart your desire to return to them, then follow my lead and walk forth. That hope will surely guide you true.
You mean to return to the world where you are hailed as a hero. Hear me then. Not as a hero, but as simply you. As I learned in Alamigo, you are a formidable foe. Stronger than any I have faced. Against you, I need bring my all to bear. I need burn through the candle of my life. This is the sole pleasure I know, and it is the sole pleasure I have to share. And so I come before you to issue challenge and offer singular bliss. If you wish to walk away, I will not stop you. You value life. You do not burn yours save for reasons you deem worthy. Reasons such as those which brought you here. The salvation of a world and its people. The motives of a hero true. But there is more to you than that. You know this to be true. As surely as you know the thrill of pushing your body and soul to their limits, of confronting ever mightier foes, dancing ever closer to the precipice, wondering if this will be the one to finally, finally fill the void. Such pleasures you seek for their own sake, and no other reason. Is this not so, adventurer?
Ha! Acceptance! At long last! The conflagration of our clash will scorch even the stars! Nothing back! Push yourself to your limit and lead to mine! Fortune. Soon you will know the full extent of my power. Tell me your life's fire is already spent. Yes, yes! Rise once more! It mustn't end yet! Of your reflexes! have you! Of your reflexes! Show me your vaunted fortitude! Of me is spent.
that I should lose again. How disappointing. Never have I understood those around me, understood their obsessions. Besieged by their banality, the world is a mire of tedium and trivialities. But in these fleeting moments, there is a spark, blinding, brilliant. Too soon. What of you, my mirror? Born into this world, bestowed name, bid to seek out strife and adventure. Was this life a gift or a burden? Did you find fulfillment?
Can you hear? Safe? Must tend to... Open your... Please.
Someone, and...
Please.
Forgive you. So come on, open your eyes and get up.
Are you with us? Oh, thank the heavens. For a moment we thought... After what you've done, you're the last person to be asking that. You... How can you keep your promise if you're not here?
Another fine show you've put on, my friend.
A fine show indeed. What were you thinking, fighting alone? Never do that again. My poor heart couldn't bear it.
Put yourself in our place. If you hadn't returned, how do you think we would feel? And if that sounds harsh, it's because we care.
We tended to thy wounds as best we could, but how is the pain? That is gladdening. Grievous as thine injuries were, however, I would counsel repose for a time.
Gladdening! There's nothing gladdening about this! When Meteon appeared in here and told us that you were right behind her, we all got our hopes up. But you never came! And when you finally deigned to appear, you're within an ilm of your life! Damn you! Damn you for making us worry!
Oh, those were cries of celebration! Anyway, well, the important thing is that you're all alive and in reasonably good health, and we mean to get you back that way. As for your earlier request, I'm quite certain we're in range to make contact now.
Ah, excellent. Let us announce our return at once. I hope you're ready.
While you were unconscious, we set out from Ultima Thule, you see. Can you stand? If so, you may wish to see what's outside. We're home, my friend. We're home.
Is that... It is! It's the Ragnarok! They're back!
Thank heavens.
Truly.
They've done it!
Welcome home. Yes!
Dearest Mother, dearest Father, this letter will be the very last that I write to you from the Rising Stones. As I commit these words to parchment, I fondly recall my journey as a Scion. From the time I first walked into the Order's former halls, to the time I set forth to forestall the final days. At the farthest reaches of the Sea of Stars, we fought the battle of our lives. Fought against despair itself, a veritable maelstrom of it, fed by the resignation that dwelled in the hearts of beings not so unlike ourselves. Full oft have I harbored the same malaise, have I been brought to my knees, crushed by the weight of sorrow and defeat, convinced that I will never rise again. However, I have also known many moments of unbridled joy and happiness. By this truth do I find hope within, blooming resplendent, like the Elpis flower. And thus do I endure. do I look forward to creating more memories with my friends and loved ones. For from these fertile seeds, yet more hope shall spring forth, and they will grow to become shining lights that illuminate the dark. Thus believing, I leave the rising stones behind, as will my comrades. For, as we have decided, after careful deliberation, we are disbanding the Scions of the Seventh Dawn.
There you are, Alphino. Everyone is already gathered in the foyer.
My apologies. I'll be right there. At least, that is what the story will be. Sorry to keep you all waiting.
What could you possibly have left to do now?
Oh, just a letter.
I imagine it will be a while before we can gather like this again.
So it must be, if we're to keep up appearances. From now on, it falls to the Grand Company of Eorzea and its allies to deal with the realm's crises.
Meanwhile, we shall return to our erstwhile ways. Retreating from plain sight to take our place in the shadows once more.
Indeed. For the foreseeable future, I expect that we must work independently as we seek out problems that want for solving. But a day will come when we face another great challenge, and we will face it together, as we always have.
As much as I look forward to that day, I do hope it doesn't come anytime soon.
Well, formal association or no, if any of you should require my services, you need but ask. I'll be glad to keep my lance arm honed.
I'll hold you to that. So you had better keep your link pearl on hand.
So you really mean to stay, Totaru?
Oh, someone has to keep the Rising Stones in proper order. And even a super-secret organization requires a super-secret base of operations. To the rest of the world, it will be naught more than a workshop for Eorzea's foremost up-and-coming artisan. If you thought our coffers were full to bursting before, just wait till I can devote myself wholly to the crafts.
Plotting to build a mercantile empire to rival that of Lord Lodorito, are we?
I, for one, look forward to your future successes, Totaru. As do I our next meeting.
And with that, I believe it is past time you all made ready to depart. Leave no preparations undone or words unsaid, all right? Now, off with you.
I suppose we're off to Garlemald then. Though we ought to speak with Lord Emmerich first. If he's received word of any recent developments, we need to know.
'Twould be prudent to purchase some warmer clothes at least. Mayhap we can pick up a few souvenirs for Eulis and the others while we're at it.
Where will you all be heading next?
Dravania. There is a book I've been meaning to borrow from the Great Google Library. And I can think of at least one person who would be most displeased should I fail to visit before leaving.
We've no particular destination in mind, but we do intend to stop in Charlian before we set off.
We had thought to ask after the Loperits. I am curious as to how well those who chose to remain are adapting to their changed circumstances.
Might we accompany you then? Raha and I were planning to return to the Baldessian Annex.
Commissions have been piling up in our absence, and they must be dealt with ere we begin our work in earnest.
Estinian, you will return to Rads at Harn, will you not?
Aye. For Vritra's benefit, though I've yet to hear the details, I may not stay long.
I see. Then it is here the Scions at last part ways, each to some far-flung corner of the realm.
Perhaps. But I believe one of our number, a rather important one at that, has yet to divulge her plans.
Quite right.
Indeed.
Fair point.
So, what's next for our humble adventurer?